Macmillan Audio presents A Piece of Good News. Written and narrated for you by Katie Peterson. Very well, Socrates. What are your instructions to me and the others about your children or anything else? What can we do that would please you most? Nothing new, Crito, said Socrates, but what I am always saying, that you will please me and mine and yourselves by taking good care of your own selves in whatever you do, even if you do not agree with me now. But if you neglect your own selves and are unwilling to live following the tracks, as it were, of what we have said now and on previous occasions, you will achieve nothing, even if you strongly agree with me at this moment. Plato, Phaedo. A Piece of Good News. The Border. I had a lust for what was distant. We were in love. We crossed the border in broad daylight, and the color of the currency deepened but didn't change the night before we made love in my sister's bed. The coastline shivered and the wind picked up. You lit a cigarette inside the car. The potholes made a song of ruin so consistent no one noticed. Vacation homes more proximate than gas stations. The language on the radio didn't change. When I was hungry, you took me to the movies. When I was tired, we went looking for a shopping mall to purchase a pair of shoes like the locals wear, not local. Later, we chose a bar because someone shouted at us. You felt guilty I paid a man to shine my tall black boots, but kept staring at the stripper who must have rubbed her breasts with lotion before she came to work. The whole way home, I was never sicker. I drank the water. I thought it was okay. We talked about people we fucked when we should have been sleeping with each other. Pleasure. I remembered what it was like. Knowing what you want to eat and then making it, forgetting about the ending in the middle, looking at the ocean for a long time without restlessness, or with restlessness not inhabiting the joints, sitting Indian style on a porch overlooking the water, smooth like good cake frosting. And then I experienced it, falling so deeply into the storyline. I laughed as soon as the character entered the picture, humming the theme music even when I told myself I wanted to be quiet and not talk forever. And I thought, now is the right time to cut up your shirt. A citizen. I wanted to be seen, but who would see me? I couldn't think of the name for anything but a flower. The government makes coins that size and shape so your hand can feel safe holding them. The pictures stamped remind us where we are or how the landscape we live in connects itself through a common value to a different place. On this one, a spinnaker sails past a bridge. On that, a diamond shines like a child's stilled top over a bird, as if the diamond made the rest of the natural world, bird, forest, state flower, sheaf of healthy corn, shining water, out of proportion in relation to itself. I love this. My own state has a bear, so small and out of proportion to me that my lifeline crosses behind it. At last, I do not fear that, but feel proud the animal can sit in my palm so silently until I spend it. And if I lose it, it becomes even more quiet. Most still just have an eagle, so it is as if 30 eagles were passed over from one hand to another when the one charged with arranging things for his savior's dinner arranged his savior's death. Heavier the yoke of heat in solitude. A walk uphill does not feel manageable. Who will see me? Opera. The next morning, I tried to remember her face, but her dress sailed into the center of my eye, a ship luscious with sail, crossing no horizon, but stopping where I knew my nose was, that ridiculous mountain only lovers find right ways to compliment. But then I tried harder to call it back, and my eyes rose to meet her décolletage and her shoulders and the manner in which her clavicle hinged at her neck, to sing with such dexterity she could stomach a world of old and rich and earnest admirers. And so what I remembered came from a pose I can recall, though his hands were around me in such a way I could only watch sideways and still be loved. And what I remembered could not be said to appear at once at the top of a tall tree like the endangered condor from a hiding place in some remote part of California, or likewise over the ocean like a salt-crusted hawk. She made the most sexual face I had ever seen when she described why she sold her possessions. Happiness. They had decided against it. But then they entered the field of sunflowers, together after some pictures had been taken, with a storm in the background, the shape of a fist, and wrinkled like a raisin, the color of the strong liquor made from raisins they had yet to taste.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.